we see around here a lot of talks about startups and entrepreneurship, which is comparable with top salary jobs. So the question is, how do we analyze it, or how should we analyze it? What is it according to you, sir?
See, firstly, you have to understand the difference between a business, a startup, and entrepreneurship.
Entrepreneurship, yeah.
You cannot even cut an onion without learning how to hold a knife.
A knife. So, हमारे आज के बहुत ही खास मेहमान, हमारे आज के गेस्ट, मिस्टर निसार नाडियाडवाला सर आज हमारे साथ जुड़े रहेंगे. आप सभी लोग इनके बारे में जानते हैं, एन एक्सेलेंट एजुकेशनिस्ट, एन एक्सेलेंट कोच, एक मेंटोर बुलाओ इन्हें या फिर एक बिजनेस एडवाइजर बुलाएं, बहुत सारे डिसिग्नेशन इनके पास है ऑलरेडी. एक पैकेज में बोल सकता हूँ जो कि जिनके पास इल्म भरा हुआ है अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह. और ऐसे एक शख्सियत के साथ हमें आज कुछ इन्फॉर्मेशन हासिल करने का मौका मिला है. ये मेरे लिए और हमारे घर बैठे दर्शक हजरात के लिए एक बहुत ही बड़ी खुशी की बात है.
मैं तमाम ऑडियंस को सलाम अलैकुम रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू.
वालेकुम अस्सलाम.
मेरी जानिब से आप तमाम लोगों का इस्तकबाल आपके चैनल के तरफ से और बम्बई की तरफ से.
द क्वेश्चन इज, व्हाई डू मेनी पीपल फाइंड बिजनेस सो डिफिकल्ट?
दिस इज द हाउस ऑफ अ स्पाइडर, वेरी वेरी वीक हाउस. द कुरान आल्सो सेज इट इज द वीकेस्ट हाउस, बट if you broom it away, yet it will go to the other corner of the room and start building again. People should be taught not to be afraid of failure. We are afraid of failure because in our schooling system we are encouraged to be topper.
Let's talk about the people who are not into business now. Like for example, one option that we get always is go into a business, ya fir dusra hai work for someone or be an employee or work under someone. अब द पर्सन हु इज़ एन एम्प्लॉय, उनके दिल में भी कुछ ऐसे आस आ सकते हैं कि यू नो इवन आई नीड टू हैव अ साइड बिजनेस, या फिर दूसरों को देख के वो एक इंटरेस्ट पैदा हो जाता है कि शुड आई लीव दिस जॉब. व्हाट डू यू एडवाइस, हाउ कैन अ पर्सन इन जॉब लर्न बिजनेस?
ही इज एन एक्सपर्ट इन हिज फील्ड,
या
वेदर ही इज इन टीचिंग, वेदर ही इज एन आईटी इंजीनियर, और वेदर ही इज अ ऑटोमोबाइल इंजीनियर, इलेक्ट्रिक इंजीनियर, व्हिच एवर फील्ड इज ही इन. He has become expert as compared to the many newcomers.
मेरे student life की अगर मैं बात करूँ तो I used to get excited by these, you know, the small shops which were near the college, our college. The shops were usually related to stationery, the printout shops, the Xerox machines. I could see all of them in a line. और इतने सारे customers भरे हुए रहते थे just because of the location. कभी कभी मुझे लगता था कि मुझे स्टूडेंट लाइफ छोड़कर मुझे ऐसे शॉप्स डालने पड़ेंगे, यू नो एक फीलिंग आ जाता है. कुछ लोगों को एक इंटरेस्ट होता है बिजनेस में जाने का बट कर नहीं पाते ड्यू टू द लैक ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन, ड्यू टू द लैक ऑफ गाइडेंस. अब हर प्लेस में हमें निसार नाडियाडवाला सर तो मिलते नहीं, सो दैट वी गेट एजुकेटेड रिगार्डिंग द बिजनेस स्टफ. अकॉर्डिंग टू यू, व्हिच आर द मिस्टेक्स कॉमनली मेड बाय द न्यू बिजनेस?
नंबर वन,
ओके,
दे डोंट स्माइल. If you cannot smile, you can never be a businessman.
Okay.
Number two, they don't learn accounts. Oh, I am a literature student. I am an engineer. I am an IT. I am a doctor. What should I learn? Accounts. Okay. You have to learn accounts. Business is in your book, not in your pocket.
चाहे science के students हो, चाहे arts के students हो, commerce का कुछ तो knowledge होना चाहिए. Okay.
Even if she is a housewife.
Even if she is a housewife.
Accounts को लिखना आना चाहिए. Salary, husband की आ रही है, कहाँ जा रही है.
बैलेंस शीट का नॉलेज होना चाहिए हमारे पास,
होना चाहिए.
ठीक है, चल.
At least nobody will, you know, fool you.
Is business a good opportunity for the educated ladies who are managing the domestic duties?
65% of online business in India is done by females. These are the statistics.
Oh.
People on Amazon, people on Udemy, on LinkedIn, they are all our sisters. They are, many of them are staying in remote villages, small towns, just with the help of a laptop. They are teaching, they are coaching, they are doing business, they are doing, they are earning.
That's,
and they are focusing on their family. Jazakallah khairan. I feel very highly honored to be on your channel and in your homes, on your screen. I'm very happy. बहुत अच्छा लगता है आपके घर में आकर बगैर चाय पिए आपकी मेहमान नवाजी, आपकी तवज्जो मैं हासिल कर रहा हूँ. लेकिन मैं जाते जाते बता दूँ,
अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू. कहिए जनाब, दीजिए जवाब. में आप सभी का इस्तकबाल करते हैं मेरे अजीज़ दोस्तों, प्यारे भाइयों, बहनों और बुज़ुर्गों. हर बार की तरह आज के इस एपिसोड में भी हम आपके लिए एक बहुत ही बेहतरीन और एक इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक लेकर आए हैं। दोस्तों, आप सभी लोग ऑलरेडी जानते होंगे आज का टॉपिक और हमारे आज के गेस्ट, क्योंकि कुछ ही दिन पहले सोशल मीडिया में एक पोस्टर सर्कुलेट हो रहा था जहां पर कमिंग सून के नाम पर हमारे गेस्ट का नाम और हमारे आज के इस एपिसोड का टॉपिक सर्कुलेट हो रहा था और लोग हैरान रह गए कि क्या ये टॉपिक भी अभी कहिए जनाब में आने वाला है। जी हाँ दोस्तों, बहुत ही हैरानी की बात है और एक खुशखबरी भी है हम सभी के लिए कि आज हम कुछ ऐसे टॉपिक को कवर करेंगे जो कि बिजनेस से रिलेटेड है। जी हाँ दोस्तों, बिजनेस ट्रेंड्स आज का टॉपिक रहेगा और इससे रिलेटेड जितना इन्फॉर्मेशन हो सके हम आज वो कलेक्ट करेंगे और ऐसे इन्फॉर्मेशन कलेक्ट करेंगे जो कि शायद ही कभी हमने उसके बारे में ना तो सोचा होगा ना ही हमें उसके बारे में इल्म रहा होगा। तो दोस्तों, अब यहाँ पर सवाल ये उठता है कि एक ऐसे टॉपिक के लिए हमारे साथ एक ऐसे टॉपिक के बारे में डिस्कस करने के लिए या फिर सवाल जवाब का सेशन करने के लिए हमारे साथ कौन जुड़े रहेंगे। दोस्तों, हमारे आज के बहुत ही ख़ास मेहमान, हमारे आज के गेस्ट मिस्टर निसार नाडियाडवाला सर आज हमारे साथ जुड़े रहेंगे। आप सभी लोग इनके बारे में जानते हैं, एन एक्सेलेंट एजुकेशनिस्ट, एन एक्सेलेंट कोच, एक मेंटोर बुलाओ इन्हें या फिर एक बिजनेस एडवाइज़र बुलाएं, बहुत सारे डिसिग्नेशन इनके पास है ऑलरेडी, एक पैकेज में बोल सकता हूँ जो कि जिनके पास इल्म भरा हुआ है अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह। और ऐसे एक शख्सियत के साथ हमें आज कुछ इन्फॉर्मेशन हासिल करने का मौका मिला है, ये मेरे लिए और हमारे घर बैठे दर्शक हजरात के लिए एक बहुत ही बड़ी खुशी की बात है। तो आइए बिना वक्त को बर्बाद किए हम यहाँ पर इनका वेलकम करेंगे, इस्तकबाल करेंगे। शेख, अस्सलाम वालेकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातहू।
वालेकुम अस्सलाम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातहू।
हाउ आर यू सर? अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह, हाउ आर यू सर?
अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह, क्वाइट फाइन, जस्ट लाइक यू, यू आर फाइन एंड आई एम फाइन।
Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah. So, it's for the first time that we have invited Mr. Nissar Nadiadwala sir on our show, that is Kahiye Janab Dijiye Jawab Season 2. Alhamdulillah, it's a very fortunate moment for me as well as our audience, sir. So, right now, I'm in Udupi and sir is in Bombay, mashallah. Hamare technology ke wajah se, advanced technology ke wajah se, hum aaj sir tak connect ho paaye hain. Waise to sir, Udupi bahut bar aaye hain, lekin unfortunately, mujhe milne ka mauka nahi mila. शायद किसी ने मुझे इनवाइट नहीं किया होगा सर उस वक्त, या मे बी आई वाज वेरी यंग एट दैट टाइम, लेकिन अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह अल्लाह ने एक ऐसा मौका दिया है जहां पर हम ऑनलाइन से, ऑनलाइन के ज़रिए से हम सर तक कनेक्ट हो सकेंगे। अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह सर इज़ ऑनलाइन विद अस एंड आई होप बहुत सारे ऑडियंस हमारे साथ अभी फ़िलहाल जुड़े होंगे, चाहे वो टी वी पर हो या फिर यूट्यूब पर हो या फिर किसी भी प्लेटफॉर्म पर हो। और सर, मैंने हमारे ऑडियंस को आज का टॉपिक भी बता दिया है, बिजनेस ट्रेंड्स। एक्चुअली ये टॉपिक बहुत दिनों से सर्कुलेट हो ही रहा था कि कहिए जनाब में निसार नाडियाडवाला सर आने वाले हैं और बिजनेस ट्रेंड्स पर बात करेंगे। और अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह ये एक बहुत ही यूनिक टॉपिक होगा आज का, यूनिक टॉपिक बिकॉज ये एक ऐसा टॉपिक है बिजनेस जो कि मुझे लगता है कि हर इंसान, एवरी ह्यूमन बीइंग किसी ना किसी लाइफ के अपने मोड पर एक ऐसा थॉट ले आता है वेयर ही थिंक्स दैट आई नीड टू स्टार्ट अ बिजनेस, अपने एज को भूलकर, अपने कैटेगरी को भूलकर कहीं ना कहीं एक थॉट आ ही जाता है कि आई शुड स्टार्ट समथिंग, यू नो, इन द फील्ड ऑफ बिजनेस। वो कुछ भी बिजनेस हो सकता है। फॉर एग्जांपल, अगर मैं स्टूडेंट, जब मैं मेरे स्टूडेंट लाइफ की अगर मैं बात करूँ तो आई यूज टू गेट एक्साइटेड बाई दीज, यू नो, द स्मॉल शॉप्स विच वेर नियर द कॉलेज, आर कॉलेज। The shops were usually related to stationery, the printout shops, the Xerox machines. I could see all of them in a line. और इतने सारे customers भरे हुए रहते थे just because of the location. कभी कभी मुझे लगता था कि मुझे student life छोड़कर मुझे ऐसे shops डालने पड़ेंगे, you know, एक feeling आ जाता है। वो चाहे student life ही नहीं बल्कि एक नौकरी करने के वाले के दिमाग में भी these type of thoughts usually come. तो ये एक ऐसा एक aspect है, एक ऐसा एक topic है जहाँ पर People are confused usually. आगे बढ़ना है या नहीं, you know? तो आगे बढ़ने से कभी कभी अपने आप को इंसान रोक लेता है because of the various issues. और कभी कभी without proper guidance इंसान आगे बढ़ जाता है. तो these are the things which, you know, lack of guidance के वजह से हम कभी कभी fail हो जाते हैं, कभी कभी हम जीत जाते हैं इस मैदान में. But मुझे ये लग रहा है कि अभी भी हमें इसके इस मामले में गाइडेंस की ज़रूरत है। तो अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह आज हमारे पास एक एक्सेलेंट मेंटोर, एक एक्सेलेंट बिजनेस एडवाइज़र, एक कंसल्टेंट हमारे साथ हैं। तो शेख, क्या आप रेडी हैं? कुछ सवालात मेरे पास हैं हमारे, जो कि हमारे ऑडियंस के दिमाग में भी होगा। सो आर यू रेडी शेख?
श्योर, इंशाल्लाह।
या जज़ाकअल्लाह।
सो सबसे पहले मैं तमाम ऑडियंस को सलाम अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातहू।
वालेकुम अस्सलाम।
आप तमाम लोगों का इस्तकबाल आपके चैनल के तरफ से और बम्बई के तरफ से और खास करके मेरे मेरे फैमिली के तरफ से.
JazakAllah Khaira, that's so sweet. Ji, a very warm welcome to you on behalf of Nothing Much Productions and you channel and the entire citizen of Udupi and Bangalore. Ji, sir, we see around here a lot of talks about startups and entrepreneurship, which is comparable with top salary jobs. So the question is, how do we analyze it or how should we analyze it? What is it according to you, sir?
See, firstly, you have to understand the difference between a business, a startup, and entrepreneurship.
Yeah,
these days if you go to the YouTube, there are many speakers who will tell you to do startup, entrepreneurship, and they all collect millions of viewers. If you have noticed it. And suddenly that there appears a scenario or a trend which tells us that if you are, it's very easy to start entrepreneurship, it's very easy to start startup. Nobody talks about the training required for it. You cannot even cut an onion without learning how to hold a knife.
Exactly.
So people just show dreams, and there are many such so-called motivational speakers on entrepreneurship.
Exactly.
There are more speakers on entrepreneurship than on any other field, except weight loss. So people have been, you know, misinformed. Like it's working more like, I can say it is working more like painkiller. That they show you dream, they show you about Elon Musk, they show you the owner of Amazon and on and on and on. They keep on showing you all this stuff. And everybody thinks that I can become Elon Musk, I can become, I can start my own. Yes, but it is not reality. Like for example, in cricket, you see Tendulkar, you see Sunil Gavaskar, you see many other cricket players, and you see footballers, Ronaldo, Messi, then you think you also can be like that. There are millions of people who are not. They have been playing football for years and decades. So the thing is that we are not trained about business. And the difference between, as I said, startup is something to initiate a small project, an idea which is in your mind. Fine, that is just, it can be anything. It can be a laundry shop, it can be a cafeteria, it can be a shop like you see outside
also
the college.
Also any form of service,
Yes, that is startup. Entrepreneurship is to sell milk in form of ice cream. It's called entrepreneurship. You tickle the luxury of the people. You know, you just buy, you buy milk, and you turn it into ice cream. So the cost of the milk is 70 rupees kilo, liter. You turn it into ice cream and sell it for 200, 300, 400, 800 rupees.
Okay.
So actually this is actually entrepreneurship.
Correct.
To be very honest, I'm very honest.
Yes.
That is why I always say people, I always tell people that they should, if they are interested in business, they should go for traditional business, conservative business.
Okay.
Yes, and this actually you can say startups, conservative style of business, like begin small and grow big. And whenever I host a seminar on this, I always call it begin small and grow big. Don't see dreams, don't take huge loans of millions of rupees and then one day you run away. You're not able to digest.
Correct.
So it is better to start small, and I know there are many people in Dubai. When I was in Dubai, I was studying business from real life, not from colleges and all. I have met people who have no less than 20 to 25 small cafeterias. Small cafeterias.
Okay.
Not one big restaurant with a brand, no. But they earn more. They have four Mercedes and two BMWs. So this is called startup. Begin small and grow big. There is no need to be build brand and, you know, think about becoming like Jeff Bezos and Bill Gates. That is, if it is written in your destiny, you will become. But on the foundation level, you have to learn business.
So this is the basic part. Yeah.
The beauty of the traditional business is that you don't have to be a handsome, dynamic, digital marketeer. You don't even have to be very rich. You don't have to become influential also.
True,
you can
true,
start.
True.
like millions of Indians are already doing this businesses.
Yeah.
On streets, in shops, in malls, everywhere. They are not branded.
Yeah.
And they are real businessmen.
Yeah. Jazakallahu khaira. Thank you very much, sir. Sir, if we have to talk about the people who enter the business, like for example, you told about the startup. सोचो कि एक आदमी बिजनेस एंटर करता है वो और फिर उसको उसमें नुकसान हो जाता है. सो देर इज सम काइंड ऑफ नेगेटिविटी दैट कम्स इन हिम. ओके. और अगर कोई स्टार्ट करने का सोच भी रहा है तो दूसरों को देखकर, दूसरों के नुकसान को देखकर ही स्टॉप्स हिमसेल्फ. सो द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाई डू मेनी पीपल फाइंड बिजनेस सो डिफिकल्ट.
बिजनेस इज डिफिकल्टी इन बिजनेस इज वन थिंग.
Okay.
And failing in business is another thing. First, we will talk about difficulty in business.
Yeah.
In our entire schooling life, there is not a subject which teaches us business or startup.
Mm-hmm.
Because all our teachers are employees. They have never done business in their life.
Okay.
Yeah. Even if you give them a textbook on business, they will not be able to teach.
Exactly.
Because they don't have real life experience.
Mm-hmm.
So business is a life skill. Like I cannot teach you biryani on YouTube only.
Exactly.
I have to stand with you.
It is something which is practical, we are trying to say. Yeah.
Life skill.
Yes.
It has to be learned practically, like swimming, yes, like driving cars. That is why people find it difficult, because they don't know where to learn from.
Hmm.
Now we come to talk about the failures in business.
Hmm.
You see, failure is everywhere. When a boy goes to college, he has already been rejected by many girls. Sometimes,
yeah,
he fails in school also. Sometimes he does not score good.
Yeah.
There are people who have failed in marriages also, but they try and get up and get married again.
Correct.
Right? The failure is everywhere. You can see a cat and a kitten. The kitten tries to catch a mouse.
Yeah.
But the mouse runs away many times. Out of four, three times the mouse escapes.
Yeah.
Even the cat is also failure. But then it keeps on, you know, getting back. You see the house of a spider. Very, very weak house. The Quran also says it is the weakest house. But if you broom it away, yet it will go to the other corner of the room and start building again.
Mm-hmm.
So okay. Failure is everywhere with everyone. The people should be taught not to be afraid of failure. We are afraid of failure because in our schooling system, we are encouraged to be topper.
Exactly. Huh.
You cannot fail. If you are failing, you are bad. You did not study well, so you fail. In business, if you fail, it means you have studied. Now, what to do?
Yes.
In school, if you have failed, you have not studied well. In business, if you fail, alhamdulillah, now, at least, thoda bahut seekh gaya. So, this is the difference.
That is
that people are afraid.
तो खुलासा ये बोल सकते हैं कि कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं होती बिजनेस में.
हो भी सकती है कई दफा हार.
जी.
What is success? Success is a
success
compilation
is about
of
learning
failure.
Something. Yeah.
Success is a compilation of failure.
जी.
What? How many times Einstein failed?
Exactly.
Before starting all those coming out with those equations and all.
Exactly.
So many people have failed. How many times the people who built the first aeroplane failed?
Failed.
But today their grandchildren and children are getting so much of royalty.
Hmm.
Failing is a part. We should be told that failing is a part of life.
Exactly.
It is not, but because of our education only encourages and cheers people who come top. They are awarded because they stand first in school. So that is why this concept of failing is bad remains in our mind. I always say failing is good, but in business, your failure should be calculated. You should not invest huge amount of money, your father's money, your money, or somebody else's money, and then say, I failed, it is okay. No.
Mm-hmm.
You should be calculated. That is why I always say, begin small.
Ji.
So that the loss is also less, and your encouragement remains there, your energy remains there.
Yeah, correct. Thank you very much. Ji. Sahi baat hai. Thank you very much, sir. That was really informative. Sir, let's talk about the people who are not into business now. Like for example, one option that we get always is go into a business. Ya fir dusra hai, work for someone or be an employee or work under someone. अब द पर्सन हु इज एन एम्प्लॉय उनके दिल में भी कुछ ऐसे आस आ सकते हैं कि यू नो इवन आई नीड टू हैव अ साइड बिजनेस, या फिर दूसरों को देख के वो एक इंटरेस्ट पैदा हो जाता है कि शुड आई लीव दिस जॉब, या समथिंग सिमिलर टू सच सिचुएशंस और सम थॉट्स में कम टू देयर माइंड. सो व्हाट डू यू एडवाइस, हाउ कैन अ पर्सन इन जॉब लर्न बिजनेस?
अ पर्सन हु इज इन जॉब फॉर 10 years, 15 years, ही इज एन एक्सपर्ट इन हिज फील्ड.
या
वेदर इज इन टीचिंग, whether he's an IT engineer or whether he's a automobile engineer, electric engineer, whichever field is he in, he has become expert as compared to the many newcomers.
Yes.
He should not leave the job. He should start consulting service or selling. For example, somebody is an electrical engineer. I would tell him, don't leave the job right now. Small website. Make a small website.
Okay.
Find out some new products in electronics. Sell them and take commission. Don't invest a lot of money.
Okay.
See what is the trend. What's new in the business? Some product has come worth 500, 600. Buy 10, 15 pieces and sell it on WhatsApp, on your website, on YouTube. And you know, WhatsApp is very fast nowadays.
Yes, yes.
Selling.
Yes.
Fastest. There are many people who are selling dresses also on WhatsApp.
Yes, we see a lot of people selling in on status.
Yes, so I advise these people who are in employees, who are in job, that try to remain in your own field. Try to remain in your own field and try to get business from it. It will be very easy and safe because you already know people in your industry. You already know the products. You already have the technical knowledge. You only have to risk something little bit, not too much. Side by side in the evening. For example, this gentleman, one of my friends.
Okay.
In 2002. They were my colleagues in the office.
Okay.
One of them, he made a website on films. The .com was new in those days, some 15 years ago.
Yeah.
And he built a website putting every day something new news. That heroine is working in that movie and that one is having an affair. So all that
hangama. So basically a news platform it was.
It was a film news platform.
Okay, okay.
Gossip, page 3. The other friend started working on a religious website.
Okay. Same platform but religious topic. Website. Okay.
You have any question about my religion? And he started working on that. Both of them soon found an offer of no less than 1 crore rupees. I'm talking about 2003.
Okay.
2003 or 2004.
Yeah.
They received an offer of 1 crore rupees. One of them sold off. The other said, no, I will continue to do charity.
Okay.
So the man who sold off is rich, and the man who did not sold off got a lot of opportunity in the Gulf because now he was an expert in computers and websites. Both of them are rich. They started with small. Got my point? So even they were continuing their job. So continue your job, remain in your industry and try to do something within that. Inshallah, it will be very helpful to you. Inshallah.
Inshallah, inshallah. That was really informative. Thank you very much, sir. Sir, let's talk about the upcoming question. I would like to. I already spoke about the mistakes that people tend to do in business. And in the beginning, I told about it. दैट इज़ कुछ लोगों को एक इंटरेस्ट होता है बिजनेस में जाने का बट कर नहीं पाते लैक ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन ड्यू टू द लैक ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन ड्यू टू द लैक ऑफ गाइडेंस. अब हर प्लेस में हमें निसार नाडियाड वाला सर तो मिलते नहीं सो दैट वी गेट एजुकेटेड रिगार्डिंग द बिजनेस स्टफ्स. बट आई वॉन्ट टू नो इट फ्रॉम यू दैट अकॉर्डिंग टू यू विच आर द मिस्टेक्स कॉमनली मेड बाई द न्यू बिजनेस मैन.
फ्यू मिस्टेक्स. नंबर वन.
ओके.
दे डोंट स्माइल. If you cannot smile, you can never be a businessman.
Okay.
Number two, they don't learn accounts. Oh, I am a literature student. I am an engineer. I am an IT. I am a doctor. What should I learn? Accounts. Okay. You have to learn accounts. Business is in your book, not in your pocket.
Exactly.
The real business takes place in your books. The income, the expenses.
Yes.
And it takes only 5 to 6 days, 1 hour per day to write accounts.
चाहे साइंस के स्टूडेंट्स हो चाहे आर्ट्स के स्टूडेंट्स हो कॉमर्स का कुछ तो नॉलेज होना चाहिए. ओके.
इवन इफ शी इज अ हाउसवाइफ.
इवन इफ शी इज अ हाउसवाइफ.
अकाउंट्स तो लिखना आना चाहिए. सैलरी हस्बैंड की आ रही है कहाँ जा रही है
बैलेंस शीट का नॉलेज होना चाहिए हमारे पास, टैली होना चाहिए, ठीक है चलो,
एटलीस्ट नोबडी विल यू नो फूल यू व्हेन समबडी शोज यू अ फेक अकाउंट, यू आर एबल टू रीड एंड फाइंड आउट द फ्लॉज.
चलो इंशाल्लाह.
फाइन, नंबर टू. नंबर थ्री, दे डोंट बिल्ड गुड रिलेशंस विद पीपल. बिजनेस इज नॉट अबाउट नेटवर्क दैट यू कीप ऑन डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग योर विजिटिंग कार्ड्स. इट इज अबाउट बिल्डिंग रिलेशंस विद पीपल. एंड नंबर फोर, they don't choose the right business.
Okay.
Yes, this is very important. Now, what is the right business? There are two types of business. One business is that caters the luxury of the people, like ice cream, cake, branded dresses. The buyers are very few.
Okay.
The other that fulfills the need of the society. The tea stall, the biscuit shop, the grocery, the laundry, they are the need of every family. The milk shop, nobody can stay without milk. Everybody can stay without ice cream. But without milk, it's difficult. Correct. So always prefer business that caters to the need of the society. It will be very safe, less investment, and you know, less investment and wider reach. Lot of people can benefit out of it. And it is beneficial for the society. If you go for luxury during crisis like lockdown and so, people will cut off their luxury first, but they cannot cut off their necessity. People can stop buying ice creams and cakes. People can stop buying their ice creams and cakes, but they cannot stop buying milk for their children. They cannot stop buying vegetables and fruits. These are the essential commodities. So always go in a business which fulfills the need of the society. The biggest mistake people make is they don't choose the right business.
Yes, yes.
They think, you know, business means I sit in an air-conditioned cabin and keep on ordering my servants. If you want to do business because of that, please don't do it.
Ji, ji, ji.
You have to work.
We need to have a knowledge on ethical wealth and ethical business. Yeah.
Intellectual hard work is also something as compared to physical labor.
Ji, ji, ji.
It is very tiring. Intellectual hard work is also tiring, like physical labor. So that's these are the mistakes people make.
Yeah, thank you very much for educating on the mistakes that people usually do in business. Jazakallahu khairan, barakallahu feek. Sheikh, you said something related to the homemakers, the housewives, or the people who perform domestic duties at home, especially the women. How do you look at the duties of these women who are working at home? Like, is business a good opportunity for the educated ladies who are managing the domestic duties?
Yes, there are two ways.
Okay.
One of the most common misconception among people is that Hazrat Khadija was a business lady.
Yes, yes, that's a very good example.
She was an investor.
Yeah.
She used to delegate her business to somebody like Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She knew his business skills. So she appointed him and delegated him her business. That's it. Yeah. She did not go and do business.
Yes, yes.
So a woman can delegate. She can invest from her wealth, whatever collection and savings she has. Number two, if she is capable to do business sitting at home, looking after the family and bringing up children in a good manner, civilized children, she can do business on internet. There are millions of Indians, especially the sisters. 65% of online business in India is done by females. These are the statistics. 65% of people doing business. Yes, people on Amazon, people on Udemy, on LinkedIn, they are all our sisters from India, everywhere, online. And they are, many of them are staying in remote villages, small towns, just with the help of a laptop. They are teaching, they are coaching, they are doing business. They are doing their earning.
That's
and they are focusing on their family also.
Exactly. So we keep talking about the women empowerment. So through this, we can understand how a woman through business can empower her family, her society, and the entire nation, inshallah. Thank you very much, sir. Sir, today's topic, as I told, it's business trends. So could you just tell which are the trendy business according to you?
The finest trends. You want to know, you have to go to Facebook and scroll the advertisements, education.
Okay.
as you, everybody is often nowadays, because we have this homeschooling and lockdown, so everybody has become an educationist. So this is a business which is in trend and which is still prospering, and it is going to grow 10 times. You can teach anything now. There are millions of teachers, teachings, thousands of things. Somebody is teaching public speaking, somebody is teaching how to become a good mother, somebody is having a workshop on biryani making, somebody is having a workshop on for first time mothers, somebody is having a workshop for pre-marriage workshops, like I'm conducting a workshop on pre-marriage workships.
MashaAllah.
Pre-marriage preparation. So there is a lot of thing in education, because a majority of the Indians stay in villages and small towns, and now internet is available there. So now they want to learn what the American has to teach, what the Malaysian has to teach, what the, my friend and my seniors in Delhi, Bombay have to teach. They want to learn. There is a hunger and a thirst to learn. So trend is education.
Okay.
Number one.
Okay.
If you cannot teach, you can build a business and hire trainers and teachers to teach. This is also, this is business.
Exactly.
Then the other trends are software. New softwares are coming up, apps are coming up, and a majority of the apps that are sold in the Western countries, they are built in India and Bangladesh.
Okay.
Yeah. Then content writing is another business. Business of content writing. Business of call
centers.
That's
also trending, yeah.
These are the trendy business, but in call centers, you require a lot of investment, say around 2 million rupees to begin with. It is risky.
Yes.
But content writing, hire content writers and sell your content to the different websites. You need only to sell.
Yes.
The writers will write. The graphic designer will design. You have to sell it. So the trend is teaching, apps, softwares, and then some people are selling books and clothes, which is not trendy. Everybody is doing that.
Everybody is doing, but it is not trending. Yes.
There are more sellers than buyers, especially in the cloth industry.
Correct, correct.
Unless you have some special design to stitch and exclusive, something like boutique.
Yes.
That you make a design of your own and sell it and people would buy.
There should be something unique thing about the textile stuffs.
Yes, fabric, designs. Unless otherwise, it is not so trendy. You might end up with a lot of dead stock, unsold stock.
Yes.
Yeah, that's it. So these are the few trendy business coming up.
Yes, thank you very much for... Yes. That was really informative regarding the trendy business. So, sir, we have almost come to an end of today's session. Alhamdulillah, it was really a great session. I'm sure that hamare ghar baithe darshak hazrat ko bhi bahut sara information mila hoga on today's topic. Lekin ek sawal hamare sare darshak hazrat agar shuru se dekhe hon is episode ko, to ek sawal abhi unke dimag mein aa raha hoga ki hamare aaj ke guest sir Nadiadwala sir ke upcoming projects kya hain aur
Very good. Let me tell you about myself.
Ji.
I am basically a businessman in UAE.
MashaAllah,
and that is where I actually learned business. But before learning business, I learned sales.
Okay.
How to sell. Right from my school days, in my vacation, I used to sit in my father's shop, not on the cash box, at the counter of selling.
Okay.
And I was only 14, 15 years old. My grandfather used to be very happy seeing me. He said, he's a businessman.
MashaAllah.
So this is my profession. Began from selling. I'm still a salesman.
Okay.
I sell my consulting services for new business people, people who want to start business. I consult, I give them consulting. I have built my video courses.
Yes.
Few of my popular video courses are public speaking and presentation skills for sales people, people in sales. They require presentation skills, and teachers also.
Jee.
The other courses are business. It's in Urdu, business for beginners. Then my third upcoming project now, which is already into editing, is a course on pre-investment lookouts. Be careful when you invest money in some project, in some business. Be very careful. Your money is very popular, very precious.
Yes.
You should not give it and then regret for the life that I gave away money to somebody.
Okay.
So I'm coming up with these courses. Basically, I sell courses and I offer my consulting services. Side by side, my father runs a cloth business in Mumbai, so I do help him sometimes in accounts and I give my suggestions and all. these are my, and I write for content writing also, I write for schools, I write for websites. I'm into the business of writing, speaking, training. These are my upcoming projects. I'm something within three zone only. My industry, as I said, you should be in the industry. This is my industry.
Yes, mashallah. Allah aapko aur tarakki de, may Allah grant you more and more success, sir. And we are happy to know about your upcoming projects also. सर whenever ये ऐसे सवाल जब पूछा जाता है दूसरों को कि अपने बिजनेस के बारे में, खास करके एक ऐसे इंसान के पास जिसका बिजनेस ज़्यादा चल नहीं रहा हो, तो whenever we ask about his business, अक्सर ये आंसर आ जाता है कि my business is my business and none of your business. तो thank you for telling about your business and also inspiring us. Alhamdulillah, it was a great session. हमने निसार नाडियाडवाला सर को बहुत सारे प्लेटफॉर्म्स में देखा है, चाहे वो टीवी चैनल्स में हो, चाहे यूट्यूब में हो, अलग अलग इंटरव्यू सेशंस में हो, बहुत सारे अलग अलग शख्सियत ने इनके इंटरव्यूज़ लिए हैं. अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह आज मुझे बहुत ही अच्छा लग रहा है कि मैं भी उस लिस्ट में आज शामिल हो गया, वेयर आई हैव अ फुटेज ऑफ एन इंटरव्यू विद निसार नाडियाडवाला सर. इट्स अ फॉर्चुनेट मोमेंट फॉर मी एज वेल एज आर ऑडियंस, अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह. सो थैंक यू फॉर योर टाइम सर. बहुत ही अच्छा रहा आज का सेशन और उम्मीद है कि हमारे ऑडियंस को भी पसंद आया होगा और ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा लोगों तक इस मैसेज को स्प्रेड करेंगे इंशाल्लाह और एक अच्छा एक कंटेंट हमारे सोसाइटी को दे सकते हैं अगर उनके पास अच्छा बिजनेस स्ट्रैटेजी हो तो. और साथ ही साथ मैं ये भी चाहूँगा कि एक खुशखबरी भी देना चाहूँगा मैं हमारे ऑडियंस को, दैट इज़ यू कैन ऑल्सो गेट कनेक्टेड टू आर टुडेज गेस्ट, दैट इज़ मिस्टर निसार नाडियाडवाला सर के साथ आप कनेक्ट हो सकते हैं. इफ़ एट ऑल यू हैव any business that you are going to start up, या फिर any startups or any outlets, या फिर कुछ भी अगर आपके पास business plans अगर हैं तो please आप हमारे आज के guest के साथ share करें. You will get better advices and also you will get great ideas if you keep sharing your ideas to our today's guest. Inshallah हमारे guest खुद उसके बारे में बताएंगे. शेख मैं चाहूँगा कि आप आखिरी बार हमारे घर बैठे दर्शक हजरात को, हमारे YouTube viewers को भी आप अपने तरफ से एक आखिरी पैगाम भी दें regarding today's topic, that is business trends.
JazakAllah wa khairan. I feel very highly honored to be on your channel and in your homes on your screen. I'm very happy. बहुत अच्छा लगता है आपके घर में आकर बगैर चाय पिए आपकी मेहमान नवाजी, आपकी तवज्जो मैं हासिल कर रहा हूँ. लेकिन मैं जाते जाते बता दूँ कि बिजनेस, मेरा इंटरव्यू सुनकर आप बिजनेस में एकदम से पैसे मत डालिए. मेरे कोर्सेज कीजिए, थोड़ा सा सीखिए, एकदम सा आप पैसे मत डालिए. ताकि आप पैसे वाले हैं, आपका बच्चा बिजनेस करना चाहता है, उसे भी कहिए मेरा कोर्स कर. मैंने अपने कोर्सेज बहुत अफोर्डेबल बनाया है, लेकिन वर्ल्ड क्लास के कोर्सेज बनाया हूँ ताकि आम आदमी भी उसे हासिल कर सके. तो आपको इंशाल्लाह हमेशा मैं अपनी दुआओं में याद करता रहूँगा. और मेरा ईमेल एड्रेस है speech workouts@gmail.com.
जी.
So keep in touch. Hope to see your feedback and your inputs, inshallah.
शुक्रन बारकल्लाहु फीक शेख. सो दैट वाज मिस्टर निसार नाडियाडवाला सर. सर प्रोग्राम ख़त्म करने का वक्त हो चुका है, लेकिन ऐसा लग रहा है कि अभी और हम चलाएं इस शो को और बिजनेस के बारे में जाने, सो दैट वी गेट मोर एंड मोर नॉलेज. लेकिन इंशाल्लाह कभी और मौका मिलेगा तो हम इंशाल्लाह ज़रूर आपके साथ जुड़े रहेंगे. उम्मीद है कि आप फिर से आप अपना प्रेशियस टाइम हमें दे पाएंगे इंशाल्लाह. तो आज के लिए बस इतना ही. दैट वाज मिस्टर निसार नाडियाडवाला सर. And on behalf of Nothing Much Productions, on behalf of Udupi Channel, and on behalf of the citizens and our audience from Udupi, main hamare aaj ke guest Mr. Nisar Nadiadwala sir ka tahe dil se shukriya ada karta hu for joining us. Aur umeed hai ki aane wale episode mein bhi aap hamare saath jude rahenge inshallah. Jazakallahu khair Ashir. To doston, that was today's topic, business trends. Aise hi interesting topic ke saath hum aapke samne aate rahenge. Aapke pasandeeda show kahiye janab DJ Jawab season 2 mein. तब तक आप सभी लोग अपना ख्याल रखना. स्टे ट्यून्ड विद चैनल यू. टेक केयर. अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू.